Welcome back to the vlog, man. It's K510 Automotive Group. Today, man, we got another video, man. On this video, man, I'm gonna be doing my the last finishing touches to the E36 to make it drivable. So let me show you guys what's going on with it first. So if you look, this wheel right here is straight. And this wheel is like pushed in. Let's see if I can get the angle of it. So it's like pushed in. So when I was replacing our suspension, I didn't notice that the struts were bent. So I just got new strut mounts and put the old struts back on. But after getting it back from the shop and I'm trying to align it, the left side had a lot of camber. So it was like pushed in, and like the top of the tire is actually rubbing against my strut. Let me see if I can get some, give you guys a glimpse of it. So I don't know if you can see it, but you can kind of hear it rubbing. Rubbing against that spring right there. And you see this side. See, it's not rubbing. So that's my goal, to fix my suspension. I got all new control arms, all new bushings, all new sway bar link, new sway bar. Sway bar end caps. I basically redone the whole front end of the suspension but the struts. So hopefully my knuckles aren't bent, but I think it's the strut that's causing the issue. So I got a replacement for my front struts. Shout out to Raceland. That's who I have my coilovers with, Raceland Suspension. So make sure y'all go follow them on Instagram, and yeah, man, I recommend, like, if you're looking for entry level coilover, that was my entry level coilover. So I went with Raceland and I haven't had any problems out of them. So yeah, man, if you just looking for entry level coilover, go to Raceland and try out they products, man. I do want to, I was thinking about going spec stock suspension, but I like the rod height that I'm at right now, especially when I put the bigger wheels back on, like the 18 inch wheels. I like the how it hovers right over the suspension. So it's like that wheel, I like that wheel gap to be tight, you know? So with the bigger wheels, it kind of fill up the wheel well, and then it's already sitting low on the coilover. So yeah, man, this summer, man, I'm trying to be back in a two-door, man, or at least a car. Been pushing my X5 right now, which has been reliable, but I'm ready to like start modding that too, you know. But I need me a daily too to get around it. So before I start modding the X5 and doing all the turbo stuff and blow off valves and all that cool stuff, stay tuned for it because it's coming. I figured I'll get at least one of my cars back drivable, you know. So summer is coming, the good weather is coming. So I'm trying to get ready for it. So let me bust down this box and show y'all what we got inside. So we definitely got the freshies, man. Fresh out the box. Coilovers. Fresh out the box. In case y'all didn't know, I have refreshed my engine. Well, not really refreshed. I had to refresh my cooling system. So, Mishimoto cooling reservoir setup. Got the electric fans. Mishimoto radiator. You know, I haven't got the driver yet. I did put some new hood shocks. You know, so behind the scenes, I've been kind of tinkering with it, with this car. I got a new steering rack. I put a lot of new parts on this car, man, and haven't got to drive it yet. So with these coilovers being the last thing I think I really need to do, I'm just excited to get it back on the road, man. So highway, here we come. We're going back to the highway, man. All right, man, so I'm gonna start pulling these struts off and let's go ahead and replace them. Show you guys what I'm gonna have to do to take it off. If you haven't seen my previous video when I first installed them, go check it out. It's a little throwback, you know what I mean? But if you wanna go check it out, you can look at my playlist, my YouTube playlist, and go check them out. Check out all my old videos too. Man, in case you guys are new subscribers or you know, OG subscribers. So let's get started, man. All right, guys, so now we about to get down. We about to get busy, man. I'm ready to start putting in work, okay? This suspension I'm pretty familiar with. I've been took it down plenty of times, but yeah, it's got a, it's like two bolts in the back that holds the strut. So I'll take down these two bolts back here. This one here. Oh wait, this one here. The one on the other side. And then these three up here. So that's what I'm about to get. That's what I'm about to do right now. Sorry about the recording. I'll be one deep most of the time, so I gotta get creative when it comes to recording videos. So I'm gonna try to show y'all what I'm gonna try to capture as much as I can. You know. I got a tripod too, I should start using it. But I'm just gonna show y'all before and after, so I'm just gonna pull these boys out and then put the new ones in. All right, guys, so we got the bottom half loose. It's only three bolts. It's another bolt here. Then two 18s that screw into the knuckle. So now that that's off, we gotta get these three, I think they're 13s. All right, guys, so we took out those three 13 millimeters. Now we got the strut up. So I gotta transfer this strut mount, which is probably, I think this is new. It's a new strut mount. I'll transfer that mount to the new shock. And yeah. And then we can just put everything back for the right side. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. You guys already seen it come out, so I don't wanna bore you guys with showing y'all both sides. All right, let's get back to work, you know what I mean? All right, guys, so now we got the new strut back in. Everything lined up. 13's bolted up. I left the middle nut loose. So when I get it down, I'm gonna tighten it up. So now I'm gonna move to this side. And I'm gonna do this side. This is the bad side. This is the side I really wanna see. All right, guys, so I just finished installing both coilovers. Now we're gonna see the difference in the spin when I spin the wheel. So I think, I mean, this one had to be bent, man. Boy, it wouldn't spin. Even this side, pretty straight now. Got a little bit more spin. I don't know, it's pretty,
pretty close. You know what I mean? We got the new coilovers on. And the wheel is bolted down. Before we can even spin it. So yeah, man, I'll give y'all an update later on, man. But today, for today, this is the stopping point, man. I'm done. I'm exhausted, man. So I'm gonna start back. I don't know when I'm gonna pick this video up, but the next time you see this car, it's gonna be on the ground. I got these bolts right here. Hopefully when I'm editing, I could remember that. So, yeah, just hand tight. I figure it's easier than, you know, using a vice grip to hold the shock. Just tighten it down with the weight of the car on it. But yeah, for now, man, that's it, man. That's it, that's all, man. I'll see y'all in the next clip. Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome back to the video, man. I think it's like the next day or the next week. So, I had to change up the whole configuration with the wheels for the car because tires kept rubbing on the strut. So, switch it to these wheels. So I got M3 rims with a spacer so the strut don't rub. But it's rolling now. So it's freestyle. No restriction. This side though, I think the wheel bearings are toasted.
I'm gonna put the car back on its own weight with these wheels and kind of take it around the block. Probably in this video or the next video. So I kind of want to see what else needs to be done. I'm pretty sure I gotta still do both front. I got the camera all close. To do both front wheel bearings, I know I need to do that. You know, yeah, I think I gotta do that regardless. But just for me to test drive, I'm gonna put these wheels on here. Oh yeah, I actually had it on the back.
This is brand new tires for the rear. Those tires were kind of dogged up.
Just went ahead and put some new wheels and new tires on the front. So right now we just trying to bring it back to the road, make it drivable. So I still gotta fine tune it, but I'm just glad it's back on its own weight and I can actually drive it now. You know, went from being drivable to being wrecked to now going back to being drivable. So it's gonna be a little stuff. You know, you gotta fine tune, you know? So right, let me go ahead and put these wheels on and put the car back on the ground. And I'm gonna pick this back up. All right, guys, we're about to drop this thing now. I'll take it off the jack stands. We're gonna see if the fitment is good for the rear.
The handbrake is on.
Yeah, the handbrake is on. But this ain't moving.
It do look kind of chunky though, man. I don't know.
She kind of... She got a little butt on her. The heck?
Hope this don't rub though. Should be alright.
Alright guys, so I'm gonna put this on the ground and then we're gonna check out the fitment. Make sure it's actually high up enough so the tires don't rub the body.
The front ain't rubbing, it's tucking though, but it ain't gonna rub.
You know, I'm surprised about the rear.
The rear? Oh wait. I know it ain't clear. I thought it cleared. Yeah, that's that's on the fender right there. Damn. Let me see this side. They ain't both rubbing. Yeah, we gotta lift this up. I lift up the rear. All right, man, so I gotta put it back up in the air. And I'm gonna try to raise the rear up a little bit.
All right, guys, I got the car outside.
Fitment is pretty good, it's not rubbing.
Really close, but it's not rubbing.
I was trying to move, but I think my battery takes on my first drive, but I had to get my battery charged up and put some gas in both of these cars, man. So stay tuned for the next video. Should be on my first drive back in my 836 after the crash. I was gonna get rid of this car, so I wanna thank my son for motivating me to put it back together. He said he wanna see it, you know what I mean? He's like, he wanna drive in it, he don't want us to get rid of it. So definitely gonna have a video with him on his first ride coming soon. Then he could probably let y'all know what this car means to him, you know what I mean? Like, what he liked about it. So, yeah, man. Finally got the suspension dialed in. Thanks to Raceland for the front. Thank you for the coilovers. And, after we get everything right and car back registered on the road and everything, I'm probably going to start messing with the interior. Probably getting it painted and stuff like that too, man. I want to get back to like daily driving it, you know? Kind of give my other cars a little break as I'm, you know, continue building on my other projects. And stay tuned for some X5 content too, man. I want to do some turbo upgrades, like turbo components. Kind of want to get a blow up valve and like turbo noises too, man. Stay tuned for that content too, man. But this is gonna be the end for this video, man. And it's K5 Town Automotive Group. If you can make 5, you can flip it into 10. Keep going up. Peace.